Satya Nadella.
Hi, we are here to learn about how to give inclusive presentations. And to help me do that, we have Brian Stormer from our Microsoft 365 marketing team. So Brian, welcome. I know inclusive presentations is something that's top of mind whenever you're speaking to any audience. And do you want to talk a little bit about how you go about creating an inclusive presentation?
Yeah, definitely. So we know that over 1 billion people on the planet have a disability, and 70% of those disabilities are invisible. So it's so important for you to make sure that your presentation is inclusive, because the reality is you never know who in your audience might have a disability. So right now I'm actually creating a presentation on the new Surface Go, and I want to use this as a chance to kind of show you some best practices for creating an inclusive presentation.
In PowerPoint.
So I'm going to go to Insert, I'm going to go New Slide, and then I'm going to select a section header, and I've saved some images to my desktop. So I'm going to add these. And the first thing you'll notice is that Design Ideas pops up to the right. And what Design Ideas does is it creates a really great looking slide for me in just one click. And this is all done using artificial intelligence. Another amazing thing that AI is doing is it actually generates alt text for each of these images.
That's pretty cool.
Alt text is text that basically describes each of these images. And it's important because if you're using a screen reader, you're not going to be able to know what it is if you can't actually see the images. So we need that text there to describe it. So I'm going to click on this.
Computer image.
And I go to Edit Alt Text.
Column at right.
And you'll see it says a person sitting in front of a computer. OK, well, this is great. But actually, this isn't just any computer. Again, it's the Surface Go. So let's be a little bit more descriptive and add that in here.
And this way, the AI will even learn from sort of what people are doing on an ongoing basis.
Yeah, it's amazing, and it will only get better. Yeah. So I exit out of here.
Another slide.
And right now, my presentation's looking pretty good. But something I always do before sending it out to colleagues or being ready to present is I run the accessibility checker. And what's amazing about it is it's right next to spell check. So you should really get in the habit of running both of these.
Yeah, top left, I mean, right of spell check.
Spell check and accessibility check are sort of both things that you want to do with every piece of email to every presentation going forward.
Definitely. So I click check accessibility, and it's saying that slide 2 is missing a slide title.
Right column.
And then it gives this great description of why. It says slide titles are used for navigation and selection by those who are not able to view the slide. So that sounds really important for me because, again, I want to make sure that it's easy to use for people who are using screen readers. So let's go in and add a slide title to this. And I think it's ready to present.
Images of a new surface.
And whenever I present, I love to use this feature called Presentation Translator. It basically provides live subtitles to me and to my audience when I'm presenting. So let's give it a try.
Under Slideshow at center top.
It will say, what language are you speaking and what language do you want to display the subtitles in? And what's amazing about this is I could still be speaking English and I can actually select a different language for it to translate into. And it's important for people who are deaf or hard of hearing, because if they can't hear what I'm saying, they're not going to be able to follow along with the presentation. But it's also really helpful for people who just want to take notes or for people who are visual learners.
That's awesome. I mean, all these tools, whether it's the accessibility checker or Design Ideas, alt text, the translator, all getting built in, just makes it so much easier for everyone to be really, doing their best work in creating these content, whether it's a presentation, a document, and then thinking about the audience and make it accessible and empowering everyone. But an everyday use of AI is what's, I think, super exciting.
Yeah, definitely. When we continue to invest in AI, we're going to see remarkable things for people with disabilities and in making our world even more inclusive.
Fantastic. And where can one go to learn more about this?
So people can go to aka.ms/office-accessibility to learn more.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for sharing all
this.
Thank you. It's a great set of tips.
They shake hands. Microsoft.